Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to Anna's Period Talk. So it's been a little while since I talked to you guys. Basically, the last few videos have been nothing but period vlogs every month, and it's been several weeks since I last did one. It's been about a little over 3 weeks. So I just started my period. Today is May 24th on a Friday, and it is 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I just started. Well, I've been cramping on and off for about an hour. I haven't started bleeding yet, but I know I'm itching too because these are not PMS cramps. They're actually more intense than PMS cramps. So I took me some medicine about 30 minutes ago. I haven't kicked in yet. Hopefully it'll kick in soon because it's starting to get kind of painful. But yeah, so to give you guys a little about what's been going on, really nothing's went on the past few weeks. So I finished up school, so I'm now on summer break, so that is good. I went to the dentist. If y'all didn't follow my story, before I had my last period, I had to get 4 teeth taken out, but it was like a week or two in between, so I was already recovered from that. I went to the dentist this Tuesday, about 3 days ago now. I have to get a lot of work done in my teeth. My teeth are terrible, mainly my top one. To give you guys a little rundown why my teeth are so bad is because I was born with a cleft palate, which is a hole in top of my mouth. I got that fixed, but anybody that's had a cleft palate, no matter how much you brush your teeth, no matter how much you take care of them, you're always going to be prone to bad teeth. So, I just can't help that. I was born with a cleft palate fixed. Still, it's affecting the way my teeth are, mainly on the top. The bottom, not so much. Like, the top is mainly the worst. So, I'll tell you guys an update about that soon. I actually have to go back to the dentist next Thursday because I have two cavities on the bottom that need to be filled. So, I'm going to fill those, and they're going to talk with my mom and me, mainly my mom, about stuff they need to have done and make sure it's okay with them to go do it and all that. So I'll let you guys know whenever I know more information about what's all going to be going on in the next few weeks. So yeah, this sucks because it's summertime and I have to go back to the dentist mostly all summer or until my teeth are good and everything. And I'm not letting this take up my whole entire summer. Like, this is, like, if I have some work done, like teeth pull, you know, they have to wait a few weeks. I don't want to mess with anything until, you know, everything's healed up and everything like that. But I'm just like, I don't want this taking up my whole entire summer. Because I still want to hang out with my best friend. I want to do all these different things this summer. And, you know, it's not going to be like an everyday thing, you know. Even though you get, like, if you have just one tooth pulled, or you have some teeth work done, or you have, like, several taken out, you know, like, it's kind of like you have to sit there and rest. Like, one tooth maybe that afternoon, maybe half of the day the next day, rest a little bit, because since your teeth is like close to your brain, you know, especially if you have to get a bunch of teeth out and it bleeds a lot and you have to stop the bleeding and everything, you know, it can be like a recovery process from that. So, you know, so this is going to take up my whole entire summer, and I'm not going to try to let it, because I'm still going to have, I want to have fun, you know. I don't have to worry about pain, I don't have to worry about going to the dentist. Like, I am just so, like, over it already. Like, I'm just waiting on to see what needs to be done, and go ahead and get done with, and recover from it, and then get my summer on, because your girl wants a tan, and your girl wants things, and your girl wants to go swimming, and stuff like that. So, This just annoys me so much. But yeah, so pretty much on from that. Thank you guys so much for 42 subscribers. How many subscribers do I have? I have to look, because it's been a while since I looked. I know I got 40 something, so thank you guys so much for subscribing, even though I hadn't really been filming and uploading a lot. My videos, I've kind of stopped doing those videos, so if you're wondering where those videos are, which I still have all my videos up, all my period talks up, I never deleted anything, but I decided to, like, take a break from it, not do period talks anymore. I might bring them back one day or another, but I'm not really sure, so I'm thinking about doing a Q&A. It's been about 2 or 3 months since I last did a Q&A, and I think there's several more questions that need to be answered. So, I have 42 subscribers, so thank you guys so much for subscribing if you are new here. Hi, my name is Anna, and if you haven't seen one of my videos, my name is Anna, and I am 17 years old. I don't look 17, but I am 17. I try to film as many videos as I can, but stuff has been busy lately. But kind of period related videos that you would like me to do, or if you have any kind of acne tips, like I can do. I'm also doing acne videos. Like, it's not all about periods, but majority of it's periods. But I'm also doing like my skincare routine sometimes. If y'all want to see some kind of like period acne puberty related video, leave it in the description, because I'm kind of running out of ideas. I really want to be more active on this channel, but as I say in every single one of my videos, make sure you go subscribe to my main channel, because my main channel has different other videos if you want to see me in more videos different from periods and acne and everything. Go subscribe to my main channel, because I am more active on there. It's somewhere that I just film and upload, and I really don't care about it. You know, I edit more and, you know, stuff like that. So if you want to see, click the link down below to my main channel and go subscribe to there. I have 42 subscribers on this channel, which I'm very, very thankful for. Thank you guys so much. And also, I just reached 118 subscribers on my main channel. I know it's not a lot, but it's big steps for me, because I'm not expecting 1,000. I'm not expecting to grow like Shane Dawson or grow like Jed, you know, like all those popular YouTubers. But, you know, I really like it when I, get new subscribers and get new people watching and, you know, liking my videos, commenting, and really nice things with 8. Because I'm not really, like, mainly I get a thumbs down every now and then, but, like, I don't care about that. But, yeah, so, cramps. I'm still cramping right now, but I am good. 8-minute clip almost. I need to charge this up.
Alright guys, so it's a little bit later now. It is about to be 5 o'clock in the afternoon. My period is acting funny. Okay, I've just explained this. I explained it to my mom, and my mom says sometimes it happens, but it never happened before, I don't think of, because my period is always on time. So, earlier I was feeling cramps. I actually had to get up and move around, do some sort of exercises or whatever to get my cramps to stop. I'm still having like little minor cramps, but you know, ibuprofen did help where it's not hurting. I think it's about to be out of my skin. So, about an hour ago, I went to the bathroom and I checked my pad. There's no, mainly just like yellowy, discharge. And I wiped and I seen blood on the toilet paper, but it hadn't really started bleeding where it got onto the pad yet. Just a few minutes ago, I checked back and went back to the bathroom. I'm in the bathroom right now, but went back to the bathroom. Still the same thing on my pad, nothing more. I wiped, TMI, I know. But earlier today, I used the bathroom bag, like number 2, and you know, some of that stuff was still coming on the toilet paper, and that's all I've seen, no blood there. And that's what's going on, because usually my period does not act like this at all. I've had my period since I was 11 years old, I'm 17 now. Usually my period is on time every month, and when it comes, you know, it takes a little while to start bleeding, but it don't really take this long. And I really haven't done nothing different. Like, I eat, like, about the same stuff. You know, not really on any kind of diet or nothing. I drink a lot of tea. I drink a lot of coffee, which is, like, a basic thing for me. So it's not really nothing new. I don't know, but I go and ask my, I tell my mom about it, and she's like, sometimes it happens, sometimes it takes a little bit longer to get here. It just, sometimes it doesn't. So I guess she's had the same experience before, even though she hadn't had her period in years, because she takes some control that helps, that don't make her have a period and stuff. So, yeah, she's not going through it, and the way I hear, she don't really want to go through it because she's in excruciating pain and stuff. So I kind of get her why she don't want to have it on. I kind of get why she took birth control for. But anyway, so yeah, it's weird right now. I really don't know when I'm gonna start bleeding. I'm not really sure when it's gonna start doing. I don't know, but I am hungry right now. But yeah, my period, I don't have nothing to worry about. You know, as I said, it is like every 28 days. Like today, by my phone on the Clue app that I use, it says I'm on day 27, so I'm like a day early, but that's really nothing normal. But I don't leave the house, and plus, you know, I'm not the kind of person that would go out and, you know, have sex, you know, and be afraid to be pregnant and stuff, you know, because I'm not, like, I don't even have a boyfriend. I don't even go out that much. I'm homeschooled. I stay at home most of the time. I never really go out by myself, you know, and hang out. So, you know, there's nothing to worry about with that, because you guys are wondering. And I'm starting to feel some really intense cramps again. Maybe it's starting to really start now, but I'm over it, I'm delusional about it, but yeah, so that is my weird thing, that's a little update, so yeah, I really haven't done that since last time I talked to you guys. Did I already finish watching the movie? Well, I finished watching a movie, I think I've done that before I actually started the vlog. It was earlier today, My Bloody Valentine, the remake movie that had Jensen Ackles in it. Really great movie. I highly recommend it if you like horror movies. But it's supposed to be took off Netflix on June 1st. I'm not sure if that's everywhere, like in the world, or just in the United States, but it's going to be taken off Netflix on June 1st. So I watched it one more time. I might watch it again one more time before it gets taken off, because I don't have the DVD or nothing, so it's a really great movie. But I finished watching that because I started it yesterday. I am visiting the last episode of Santa Clarita Diet. Santa Clarita Diet? Is that how you say it? How you say it? Clarita? I don't know. But I started that show, like, not even, like, a week ago. It might have been a week ago. But, like, it has 3 seasons. It only has 10 episodes. And each episode is either 30 minutes long or under 30 minutes long. So, you know, it's not really that long. I'm just going to start the last episode soon. And if you haven't heard, Netflix is not the show. So, it's not getting another season. So, I am very mad about that because I got into that show, and I'm hoping after this episode, I'm hoping they're leaving some sort of ending where it's like it's not gonna like something's not gonna be explained since it's gonna be canceled. I'm hoping it don't leave an ending like that. I kind of have a feeling it will, but I'm hoping it not, since it got canceled and you won't be able to see whatever's supposed to happen. I also just watched The Kissing Booth. That movie was good. I see what the craze was all about when it first came out. When it first came out, I was a teenage romance movie. You know, I'm a teenager. So, you know, I'm not really big into those kind of romance-y movies. In my opinion, I'm big into, like, comedy and sci-fi and all that. I'm not really big into, like, the teenage romance movies. I'll watch them, but, you know, I'm not really big into it. But Kissing Booth, I really recommend you watch it. If you're, like, late on the game like me, I recommend it. And if you've never heard it before, it's a movie on Netflix. Netflix ordered it. And they're actually getting a sequel. And I actually need to watch The Boys I Loved Before. Is that what it's called? I think it's also getting a sequel. But I need to watch that movie too. It has Noah, that cute boy that every girl fantasizes over. He played Dallas on... I know his name's Noah. I'm not... Everybody knows what I'm talking about. But anyway, so I'll talk to you guys a little bit later. I gotta discharge some more, and I'll talk to you guys in a little bit.
Alright, hey guys, so it is now nighttime, as you guys can tell. It is a little after 9. So, yeah, I have definitely started now. I started bleeding earlier, finally, so, and my cramps have increased again, but I did take some ibuprofen. It's been like 9:30 will be about an hour. So I went ahead and took some because it won't be long before I go to bed, so I can start kicking in. So yeah, and it's cold up in here. It's summertime and it's hot. We have to run the air conditioner. Our air conditioner is like central, so you know it goes off and on, but like my room is super small where like it gets super cold in here. Like it's a few good reasons. I'm sorry about the lighting. I really didn't want to turn on that light. I'm going by my TV light and my laptop light that's like right in front of me. But yeah, my room is super small. Like right behind my chest drawers over there, like which is like right behind my TV and stuff. Like there's a vent on the floor right behind there. There's also like not even like a few inches away, there's like one next to my door in my bathroom. So I have two vents close together. This house was like really very weird. I hate having the bathroom in my room. The reason why I have it, I do have the master room, but this room won't even fit my parents' stuff. I don't see how my Nana, because my Nana used to live here, and she had this room and she had queen size. I don't know how she fit her stuff in here because it's super small. Which there's a lot of changes done to this house before we moved in. After she moved out, somebody else moved in. Then when that person moved out, it was like a year. This house was like, nobody lived in it for like a little over a year because like the person that owns it, you know, he done a bunch of changes to it before he let anybody else move in. So, so yeah, this house was weird. And I really don't like how the bathroom in my room, as I said, because it's kind of burdensome, but, you know, yeah. Is there something on that wall? No, I thought that was a bug or something on my wall, but that's something else. Whew. So, yeah. I was just watching my older YouTube videos, not my period channel, but my main channel. I always go back and do that sometimes when I have nothing like else to watch. It really fascinates me because this past like 2 years, my voice has got like a little bit deeper. I really don't know why. Why would it get deeper? I'm not a guy, but I guess, you know, puberty and stuff. But like I had such like a light, squeaky voice. Like one of my videos from 2 years ago, and like my voice was like high pitched kind of, and now it's like a little bit deeper and it's weird. But yeah, so, and you wonder what this pink thing is that I'm doing that? It's a lava lamp. Yeah, right there. The lava lamp, and yeah, my phone's over here charging. And it's something about the charger that I have. I have a Motorola, so I don't have an iPhone. I do have an old iPhone, but you know, the phone that I'm using right now, it's a Motorola. But the charger that I have, which this charger came with the phone. I got this phone back for my birthday, which was in November, so I've had it for several months now. It's the Moto E5 Cruise. If you want to see about my phone and everything like that, I have done videos on my main channel, so go check those out if you want to see what's on my phone and everything. But the charger that I have that came with the phone, it is so fast. Like, it is so fast at charging. You know, it's not that fast, you know, it ain't wireless charging or nothing. I don't think that phone does wireless charging. I think it's a little bit older to do wireless charging, you know. But yeah. Also, was this behind here my last period vlog? I don't know. You can't really see it. Hold on. Let me try. Okay. So. Okay. So, the dog and the cat, these are like projects. And the projects I had to do for art this year, and you know, I do online school in case you guys don't know. It's summer for me now. I'm on some break, but I do online school, so I don't go to public school anymore. For people that are new, I took art this year, and I done these art projects. Now that last thing over there, I get to admit that ain't art projects. I just did that myself because I wanted to. I needed more room decoration, I guess. That dog and cat picture, that was actually supposed to be on that poster that which is in the middle. Was in the middle right here. Oh, that's a long finger. It was supposed to be for that, but since it was like so big and it couldn't really fit, it took so much room, the cat and dog picture, my mom said I could just, color it and just hang it up on my wall somewhere. After we got through with that, that's just a poster. Let me see if I can zoom in just real quick. This is not helping, so. Especially like different things, because we were supposed to do like some sort of abstract project, and that's when we made it abstract. By the way, I made an A on that, by the way. Then that, which has written my name, and I just done that myself, and just hung it up. So that's like new room decoration. I'm not sure if it was in my last video or not. It probably was. I don't remember. But, yeah, so. Pretty much. This lighting though, I actually like it. I've been up since about 7 this morning. Well, actually, I'm up at 6:30. I don't know why I woke up so early. My cramps are starting to die down, so that's good. I got my sweet tea here. I've been doing really, really good lately. I've been trying to knock down the sodas, which I usually drink a lot of sodas. But if I have like tea made, like sweet tea made, you know, sweet tea, you know, it's made of water and stuff, but, you know, it is the sugar and everything. It's not really that healthy for you at all, but it's something that's a little bit better than soda, you know? Just a little bit better than soda. So if I had, like, sweet tea in the house, I would just drink on that all the time. But I haven't completely, like, let go of sodas, because I like sodas, and I keep sodas in the house, which... So, yeah. If you live around the world and you live like in a different country, how y'all say it? Y'all say Coke? Y'all say soda? Tell me what y'all, I would like to hear some feedback. Tell me what you call soda or Coke or anything like that. Just let me know. I would like to know what you guys call it. I call it Coke. Sometimes I do say soda. But, you know, some people like say it differently. Let me know what you guys say. Like the soda pops or sugar energy drinks, like, I don't know, like, I know energy drinks for us is like Monster. So I will talk to you guys in the morning, and I'll see you guys later.
Hi guys, so it's about 4:00 in the morning and I woke up with cramps, and I'm trying my best not to take any medicine, and I really need to get my mom's heating pad, but it's in her closet, and they're asleep. I don't want to freak them out. Like, they know it's probably me, because they know, like, I always tell them when I start my period, so they'll know, you know. It's not like, you know, sometimes I'm kind of moody on my period, but mainly just let them know, you know, because they know I have, like, bad cramps sometimes, and, but I don't want to freak them out when they hear their closet door open, because their closet door squeaks, and... I don't even know if my dad's awake. I heard my dad awake earlier, but he could have went back to bed. So I'm going to go get the heat pad because I think that will help. It's not bad cramps. But it kind of is. If it don't settle down, I will get up and get me some milk or something and take me some medicine. But I'm going to try the heat pad first just to see. If that helps, if it does, I'm not gonna worry about it.
Hey guys, so it is now a little bit later since I last talked to you. It is a little after 7 in the morning now. You can kind of tell like the room's lighting up a little bit because it's the sun's out. I did go get a heating pad. As I said, it was in my mom's room, my mom and my dad's room. And I woke her up. I told her I'll get it, but I guess she, because I asked her, hey, can I get your heating pad? I know she'll let me, but I didn't want them to freak out, you know, and me open the closet door, because as I said, it makes noise when you open it. So I bumped at her. I said, hey, can I get the heating pad? Then I walked back up the hall to get my phone because I can't see in the closet. I want like a little flashlight where I can see it. She said, yeah, by the time I walked back there, she got up and got it for me. So maybe she went back to sleep, hopefully I didn't wake her up fully. As I got the heating pad, my cramps settled down. I went back to sleep for a little while, probably about like an hour. I woke up a while ago. Cramps again. Oh, I don't like these cramps. Like, why? I just don't like cramps. Nobody does. But I'm watching Love Realistic. If y'all never watched that show, I'm not sure if it's on everywhere in the United, everywhere. But I'll tell you guys about a minute. I need to see what their budget is.
Okay, budget. That's what I was saying.
Love Realistic is a, it's on HGTV, and basically you have a woman that renovates houses like the clients are staying in, like living in, and there's a guy and he tries to find them a new house, like a new and better house with all they need what their house doesn't have. So she tries to renovate to keep them in the house, try to make it work for them more. And then you got the guy that's trying to find them a better house that has everything they want that Hillary, which is the woman's name, can't give them. There's also a Love Realistic 2, I think. Yeah, Love Realistic 2 is especially the same thing, but it's two different people. There's a different woman and a different man doing it. I like the normal one, like the one I'm watching right now. This is actually one that I haven't seen. I've seen like a bunch of them now, like reruns, but it's really, really good. So, yeah, pretty much. I'm fixing to get up, and I think I heard my mom and my dad's both up already. They're not really morning people, but they still get up early because they're so used to it. And I'm kind of thinking about drinking some milk or eating a little something, going in and taking some medicine. Could be a while before we eat breakfast, I think, so I don't want to wait till then, so probably do that. And I smell coffee, so yeah, so I'll talk to you guys a little bit later. Hopefully I'm feeling much better, because I feel right now, so yeah, so maybe I'll open some windows and
okay,
some sunlight, what I was saying. Love Realistic is it's on HGTV, and basically you have a woman that renovates houses like the clients are staying in, like living in, and there's a guy and he tries to find them a new house, like a new and better house with all they need what their house doesn't have. So she tries to renovate to keep them in the house, try to make it work for them more. And then you got the guy that's trying to find them a better house that has everything they want that Hillary, which is the woman's name, can't give them. There's also a Love Realistic 2, I think. Yeah, Love Realistic 2 is especially the same thing, but it's two different people. There's a different woman and a different man doing it. I like the normal one, like the one I'm watching right now. This is actually one that I haven't seen. I've seen like a bunch of them now, like reruns, but it's really, really good. So, yeah, pretty much. I personally get up, and I think I heard my mom and my dad's both up already. They're not really morning people, but they still get up early because they're so used to it. And I'm kind of thinking about drinking some milk or eating a little something, going in and taking some medicine. Because it'll be a while before we eat breakfast, I think, so I don't want to wait till then, so probably do that. And I smell coffee, so yeah. So I'll talk to you guys a little bit later. Hopefully I'm feeling much better, because I feel right now. So yeah, so maybe I'll open some windows. And
alright guys, so I decided to show you a little haul. Yeah. I went to the store a few minutes ago. I had to pick up several things, so I am going to be showing you guys in this video. Mainly it's all like feminine products, so if it was like other products, I wouldn't show you unless I wanted to, but mainly this is like feminine products. So the first thing is shampoo. I just got this 2-in-1 Daily Plus Suave. You get 28 fluid ounces in here. I've used this before. It smells super good. It does super well with my hair. Next, I had to get some more ponytails. There's 31 here now because I got one out a while ago and put my hair up because I wore my hair down and it's really, really hot outside. So I just put my hair up. So 32 of these. This was only $1.50 at Dollar General, and all this stuff came from Dollar General. So yeah. So this was $1.50. And this was $3. Next, which I needed these, I got some panty liners. I need some more of these. That's just the Always panty liners. You get how many is in here? You get 20, and this was just $1. So yeah, I've been out of panty liners for quite a while now, so I just decided, hey, while I was right there, got me some panty liners. Next, the last thing is some new pads. I have these Dollar General Health Ortho Thin with Flexi Wings. To me, I need, I'm sorry about shaking this. I need wings because it feels like if you don't have the one with the wings, it just don't stick really good. So I have to have the one with the wings. So it is 24, and this is the overnight, but the overnight's longer and stuff, so you hear noise in the background, my mom's running off a stray cat. But yeah, so this says it's compared to the Always size 5 pads. So yeah, big pads. I needed some, which I wasn't completely out. I still had some, but I knew I was probably gonna need some by the time I got halfway through this period. So yeah, so anyways, that is my haul. I just got shampoo and ponytails and panty liners and pads. That's all I got, and my room is a mess. I hadn't even made my bed up today. So yeah, and the time is 12:15. Me and my mom both went to town. She had to go to the grocery store, and we just stopped by. She had to go by the Dollar General, so I just got the stuff that I needed. So yeah, so alright guys, so I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. I just got through, you know, just a minute ago showing you guys what I got from the store and everything. I will be doing like how these Dollar General Ultra Thin pads work. I'll do a review on those soon. I was thinking about doing a period storage video before I filmed that haul, but I decided not to. Well, I might do that anyway. I don't know yet. It just depends. Yeah, so I'll do a review of these soon. I know these, like, panty liners are panty liners, so these work really good. I also like the Carefree ones. They had the Carefree panty liners too, but I just got these because I was like, it was like right next to those pads. So yeah, so that is it for this period vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. Guys, if you want to see more of me and stuff like that, make sure you guys go subscribe to my main channel because I'm uploading more different videos there. So if you want to see more but different content, go check out that channel. Also, I am trying to be more active on this channel, so if you have any video requests, period related or acne related or puberty related, make sure you leave the request down below and I'll try to get to them because I am on summer break. That's probably like the 1,000th time I've probably mentioned in this video, but yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye, everybody.